Good afternoon, myself Santosh Bharti. Now I am going to discuss about the mobile communication. In last lectures, now we discussed about the design parameters of the base station and the design parameters of the mobile station. Now today I will discuss about the, now the subject code is the IC452, subject is the mobile communication, and today I will discuss about the signaling and channel access. Before going to the depth of this signaling and channel access, now I would like to know what we mean by signaling. Clear? So signaling is a procedure which convey the information which are used to set up, control and terminate the call. Right? Basically, the basic use of the signaling, it conveys the information, set up, control and terminate the calls. Basically, signaling represent by the binary data, digital data or binary representation. Clear? That's why it is called the word or code word. So signaling has to be given by the code word or generally word. What is the code word? Code word are basically the number of bits. Number of bits represent the code words. So basically the signaling in a communication system, mobile communication system, is used to convey the information, to make a setup, to control and terminate the call. Right? Then come to the channel access. Channel access, basically this is the procedure to provide the maximum or more number of available channel for the user. The maximum number of available channel for the mobile communication, for the conversation, for the connection between the mobile unit to the base station. Yeah? So in channel access, basically this part is basically the channel assignment. Channel access basically deal with the channel assignment. Channel assignment is a procedure or main aim of the channel assignment is to provide or is to increase the number of available channel without affecting the quality of services. Clear? Without affecting the quality of services, basically without affecting the performance of the communication system. So this provide more number of available channel without affecting the channel access. The procedure, the main of channel assignment is provide the more number of available channel without affecting the quality of service, without affecting the performance of the communication system. So there are so many strategies of the channel assignment which provide the maximum number of channels. First is the co-channel assignment. Co-channel assignment. Second strategies are the channel assignment within cell. And third type of strategies, channel assignment strategies. The third assignment are the channel sharing strategy. And last is the channel borrowing strategy. Channel borrowing strategy, right? So these are the basically the today I will discuss signaling and signaling the information, convey the information, set up a call, control between the base station, transmitter side and the receiver side, and terminate the call, right? And channel access, this is the procedure to provide a more number of available channel without affecting the quality of service, without affecting the performance of the communication. So there are so many strategies which are provide the maximum number of available channel. So this first strategy channel are from here to here. Co-channel assignment, within a cell, channel sharing. These are the dynamic channel assignment, DCA. And last one, this is the FCA is basically the fixed channel assignment. There are two type of strategies are used to provide the maximum number of available channel using the dynamic channel assignment strategy and the fixed channel assignment strategy. So co-channel assignment, channel assignment within a cell, channel sharing strategies are the type of dynamic channel assignment, while channel borrowing strategy is known as the fixed channel assignment. Now I am going to discuss about these strategies individually. These strategies individually means first type is the co-channel assignment. So in co-channel assignment, the number of available channels are determined by using the frequency reuse concept. Using the frequency reuse concept. Clear? If frequency reuse concept is the verified, now there is no any kind of interference or exist in the defined area. But if the frequency reuse plan not well defined, then if frequency reuse plan are not well defined, then the co-channel interference are occurred. Co-channel interference are occurred means if the co-channel are occurred, now the quality of services may be decreased. The quality of services may be decreased. Clear? So in this case, we will not get the maximum number of available channel because of the quality of services decrease means performance of whole communication are decreased. Then how to improve the performance of communication system or how to improve the quality of services? Basically, we have to decrease, we have to eliminate now this co-channel interference. Clear? When for system performance, our system performance now, co-channel interference may be minimized or eliminated. If co-channel interference are eliminated, now the quality of services improved. Quality of services improved means more number of available channels will get at the users. Now more number of users can be connected with the base station. Clear? So this is the general fundamental of the co-channel assignment. Now how to control now this co-channel interference? How to control this co-channel interference? We know that in co-channel interference, this is the one parameter known as the Q parameter. Q is the frequency reuse cofactor. Frequency reuse cofactor is key. This Q is used to differentiate between two co-channel cell. Clear? Now this is equal to how much? D by R. D is the distance between two cells. R is the radius of the cells. For example, if we have the hexagonal cell, this value is the R, radius of the cell, and suppose other cell is the now this distance and this is the this is the distance d, distance between two cells, and this is the r. So this is the general formula. This parameter q is the parameter which are used to differentiate, to find the distance between two cells. Clear? So we have to choose the proper distance between two cells to eliminate the co-channel interference. So for example, in the flat terrain. In the flat terrain, basically, the current to interference ratio is needed for 18 dB. In flat terrain, the current to interference ratio, basically this is similar to signal to noise ratio. This is the current to interference ratio parameter which determines the quality of signal received at the destination point while transmitted wirelessly. So basically, this is the parameter for flat terrain. Now 18 dB current to interference ratio are required to eliminate the co-channel interference in flat region. Now to eliminate the co-channel interference, now current to interference ratio must be equal to 18 dB, at least must be equal to 18 dB. Clear? Now we know that the one important relationship between C to I, this is equal to Q power 4 by 6 for the 7 cell cluster. Clear? We know that Q equals to D by R. So D by R power 4 upon 6. From here, first C by I 18 dB. Now the Q will become to the 4.6. Now this is equal to D by R. What about the distance? Distance D equals to 4.6R. Clear? So to eliminate the co-channel interference between two cells, what must be the distance between two cells? Now this is equal to 4.6 into the radius of the cells. Right? Radius of the circular cell. Clear? To eliminate the co-channel interference. Similarly, this is for flat terrain, and if you are using in the hilly terrain, to control the co-channel interference, because the region is not flat, sometimes the signal strength is very strong and somewhere signal strength is very weak. So to control the co-channel interference, now the current to interference ratio must be greater than at least 18 dB. This is equal to at least 24 dB. At the current to interference ratio 24 dB, now to control the co-channel interference, now Q must be equal to greater than 6R. This is the ideal situation in flat terrain to control the co-channel interference. Now the Q must be 4.6. But in general, in real environment, now this Q must be equal to 6R for the design purpose in the flat terrain. To control the co-channel interference. Similarly, in hilly terrain, now Q must be greater than 6R to control the co-channel interference. Right? Clear? So this is the what must be the distance? So distance must be greater than 6R. 6R is in hilly area. When you want to control the co-channel interference, now the distance between two cells must be greater than 6R. If you are controlling the co-channel interference, ultimately improve the quality of services. If quality of services are improved, now more numbers of channels available for the conversation. More number of channels are available to connect the base station from the mobile unit. Clear? So this is the procedure to determine the number of available channels, right? In co channel interference, basically there are two strategies are used. One, 18 dB C by I are used for the flat terrain, 24 dB C for I are for this situation. Clear? In general way, when we divide the geographic area into the smaller number of cells for standard value, this R, suppose this is the R1, and when you assume other cells like this, this is the smaller cell. Suppose its radius is R2 and this is R1. For the ideal situation, when we divide the total geographic region into the smaller cells, now this R1 must be equal to 10 miles. R1 must be equal to 10 miles. Now it is used to control the standard traffic, means heavy traffic, and this radius, this is the channel assignment which are used to control the local traffic. Clear? This is used to control the local traffic. So this is basically the co-channel assignment strategy to control the co-channel interference. If you are controlling the co-channel interference, definitely it increases the quality of services or increases the available number of channels for the users for the mobile unit. So this is the first strategy. Similarly, second strategy, channel assignment within cell. In second strategy, now we know that the first strategy, co-channel assignment. Now frequency use concept are used to determine the number of available channels. Basically, in frequency you use planning, Q is the parameter which are used to find the exact value of the distance between two cells to eliminate the co-channel interference. Similarly, in the channel assignment within a cell, where the near end to far end ratio is the parameter which are used to determine the number of available channel within a cell. So this is equal to, this is the ratio, basically this is the ratio path loss due to D2, path loss due to D2 distance divided by path loss due to D1 distance. Clear? Where D2 is the near end distance and D1 is the far end distance. For example, suppose we have a cell, and here this is the receiver. Suppose here transmitter 1, suppose here transmitter 2, this distance is D2, and this distance is D1. So D1 is the far distance, D2 is the near distance, and this cross represent the receiver. Clear? This distance is receiver. So what is the mathematical relationship? This is equal to 40 log 10 divided by D2 by D1. Clear? So this is the equation of the near end to far end. So for the channel assignment within a cell, the near end to far end ratio is the parameter which are used to control because of the interference due to near end to far end ratio, which degrade the system performance, will degrade the quality of service. Quality of service are degrades, now the number of available channels are decreases. How to improve the number of available channels to the users? Basically, to control the near end to far end ratio. To control the near end to far end ratio and also control the filter, receiver filter characteristic. How to improve? How to improve? Improvement by 1, to control near end to far end ratio. How to control near end to far end ratio? Basically this D2 by D1, this D2 by D1, not D2, this ratio D1 by D2, D1 by D2 means far end ratio to near end ratio must be equal to 10. If you are putting our D1 by D2 ratio is equal to 10, and second, the filter characteristics, receiver filter characteristics equals to 10 dB per octave. Now you have to control the near end to far end interference. When you control the near end to far end interference, basically you have to improve the quality of services. Here, when quality of services are improved, basically number of available channels are, you will get the more number of available channels. So this is the strategy which are provide the more number of channels for the communication purpose. Clear? Now third strategy are basically channel sharing. Channel sharing strategy. In channel sharing, if the local traffic are more, now the first cell requests to the adjacent cell to share their frequencies. Clear? Third strategy are the channel sharing. In channel sharing strategy, depending upon the local traffic condition, a group of frequency channels may have to share between two cell sites if omnidirectional antenna are used, or share between two faces of the cell if directional antenna are used. So basically, this channel sharing is depend upon the two antennas. If omnidirectional antenna, and the directional antenna. If the directional antenna are used at the base station, then it share the frequency from one cell to another cell. If directional antenna are used, now it share the frequency of the one of the faces of the cell with the another faces of the cell, adjacent cells. So these are the procedure. So procedure first, now channel sharing in the omnidirectional antenna. Here, in omnidirectional antenna, basically we have, in this cases, suppose we have two cells. This is cell 1, this is the cell 2. This is the cell 1, this is the cell 2. Each cell assigned the 45 channels. For example, assume that again, this is again the 45 channel. 45 channel, and this is F1, F5. Not F1, F5. F5, number of 45 frequency are able to connect with the base station. This cell again, 45 channels are connected with the base station. So these are the two channels. If you are using the omnidirectional antenna at the base station, then for example, here I am going to cell 1 and this is the cell 2. This is the shared channel. Suppose here the 45 channels, and suppose 15 channels are used to share with the adjacent channel. Similarly, in here, again the 15 channels are shared with this cell. How many remaining cell? These are the 30 channels here. 30 channels are individually connect the call from mobile unit to base station, and 15 channels are able to share with the adjacent cell. Clear? So maximum number of available channels हाउ मच तो मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ अवेलेबल चैनल हाउ मच 45 प्लस 15 दैट इज द 60 मिनिमम नंबर ऑफ अवेलेबल चैनल हाउ मच 45 माइनस 15 दैट इज द 30 चैनल तो हाईएस्ट अवेलेबल चैनल फॉर द कम्युनिकेशन इज द 60 चैनल व्हेन यू शेयरिंग वन सेल विद द अदर सेल एंड अदर द मिनिमम नंबर ऑफ अवेलेबल चैनल आर लोवेस्ट अवेलेबल चैनल आर द 30 चैनल क्लियर दीज आर द प्रोसीजर फॉर द शेयरिंग द चैनल क्लियर हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द ट्रैफिक डेंसिटी हाउ टू कंट्रोल द ट्रैफिक डेंसिटी व्हेन यू आर यूजिंग द चैनल शेयरिंग स्कीम चैनल शेयरिंग इन एन ओमनी डायरेक्शनल एंटीना ट्रैफिक डेंसिटी कैन बी कंट्रोल्ड बाय यूजिंग डिफाइन द फॉलोइंग पैरामीटर Let n capital n is the number of channel per cell, t bar is the average calling time, now this value is fixed 1.76 minute, and p is the blocking probability, call blocking. Probability this is equal to 2% or this is equal to 0.02 and A n comma b is the offered load now offered load this is a function of A and n and b offered load is a function of n and b n is the number of cell channel per cell and the call blocking probability clear these are the proper following parameters which will be used to determine the traffic density at the individual cells clear there are two cases one case first what is the offered load when there is no channel sharing case second if the channel sharing then what is the offered load so coming for the case first Coming for the case first, in the first case, basically no channel sharing case. Case first. No channel sharing case. In no channel sharing case, basically. For the above example, now n is given the 45 channel per cell. 45 channel per cell and p is given 2% or 0.02 and offered load this is nb a into nb or a n is the 45 B is the 0.02. Now the value of this offered load can be taken from the Erlang tables which are given by the books by the William C. Wiley. So this value is equal to 35.6 Erlang E-R-L-A-N-G. This is the offered load. Then how to calculate the number of users? Where m is the number of users, or number of mobile unit that can be served, or number of mobile unit that can be served. So this formula is offered loan A and B multiply by 60 minute per hour divided by average calling time. Average calling time. Now here you can see the offered loan is 35.6. 35.6 and now multiply by 60 divided by average calling time. Average calling time is given 1.76. So from here you will get number of users, number of available channels is 1214. Channels are available for the conversation, for the mobile unit, for the users. Yeah, when there is no channel setting, individual channel can be used 45 channels, and there is no sharing procedure, then it will connect how much 1214 users with the base station. Yeah, case second, when channel sharing case. In the channel carrying case, now the new parameters are used to define where n1 is the parameter which is known as the number of nominal channel. Number of nominal channels assigned in the cell. N2 is the number of channels sharing with other cell. And delta n is the difference between these two, n2 minus n1 and A is the resultant offered load. A is the resultant offered load where this is equal to 1 by 2 A n1 B plus A n2 comma b minus A delta n comma b. So this formula are used to determine the resultant of a load when channel sharing procedure is done. Here and for this cases suppose we have the two channels. Individual are 45 channels and 15 channels are used to be shared. So what is the value of this n1? N1 is 45. What about the n2? What about n2? N2 is the 45 plus shared channel, that is the 60. 60. What about delta n? 60 minus 45, that is 15. Now calculate the A. 1 by 2 A 45 0.2, this is the 35.6 plus 60.02, this is the 49.6 minus 15 this is the 9.01. when you solve, you will get the offered load is 38.1 alarm. 38.1 alarm. When you calculate the number of mobile users, M is the basically this A multiply by 60 divided by T average. This is the 38.1 multiply by 60 divided by 1.76 minute. You will get, that is the 1299 users. Now you can see here, if there is no channels sharing, how many users can be connected with the base station? 1214 users. When channel sharing procedure exists, then how much? 1299 users can be connected with the base station. Basically, number of available अवेलेबल चैनल्स आर इंक्रीजेस. क्लियर? नंबर ऑफ अवेलेबल चैनल्स आर इंक्रीजेस व्हेन द चैनल सेलिंग स्कीम्स आर डन. क्लियर? व्हेन द ओमनीडायरेक्शनल एंटीना आर यूज्ड. व्हेन द ओमनीडायरेक्शनल एंटीना आर यूज्ड. सिमिलरली सेकंड केस चैनल सेलिंग when the directional antenna are used. When the directional antenna are used, now the formula is different. When the directional antenna are used, the formula is different. Now this formula, for the directional case, channel selling procedure, when for the directional cases, how we cover the whole area? Whole area means, suppose this is the cell, this is the cell, directional antenna are radiating only particular direction. Clear? So there are three directional antenna are used to cover the 360 degree. 360 degree means, this is the, there are three directional antenna. One directional antenna which cover the 120 degree, which cover the 120 degree, which cover the 120 degree. So there are 360 degree cover by using the three directional antenna. Clear? Clear? And in each cell the total are the 45 channels. 45 channel, the individual cell, how much? That is only the 15 channel. 15 channel. Now, selling procedure is done only the counterclockwise direction because of to eliminate the adjacent channel interference. If you are doing the clockwise direction, now the maybe adjacent channel interference may be exist. To eliminate the ACI adjacent channel interference, now we have to shield the channels in the counterclockwise direction. So this is the procedure of the channel shielding while you are using the directional antenna. So in this cases, basically, for example, how many channels can be shielded? Only 15 channels. So there are 3 sectors. Total channel is 45. The 45 channels are divided into the 3 sectors. Now the 15 channel. Now you can see if it is shared, if it is sharing, the available channel is 15 plus 15, that is 30. If it is not sharing, how many number of channels? That is the 15 channel only. So again, there is two cases. So case first, for the no sharing case. Case first. For the case first, no channel sharing. In the no channel sharing, the same formula is used. I mean, how much n plus 2, that is, if not sharing, in one sector there are 15 channels. N is the 15, T is 1.76, B is 0.02, R 2%. Then A equals to offer load is 15.02, this is equals to 9.01, and the number of M is the offer load multiplied by 60 minute per hour divided by average calling time, that is 1.76. So this will come, that is the 307.16 user. If there is no selling scheme, then almost 307 user can be connected with the base station. So there are 307 channels are available for the communication purpose. Case second, selling channel selling case. In the channel selling case, if the channel sharing, how much? If this channel share with this sector share with this sector, the number of available channel is 30. Number of available channel is 30. Now using the same using the offer load equals to 1 by 2 A 15 0.02 plus A 30 0.02 minus 15 0.02 by 2. It will come how much? Now this is cancelled for here. Here this it will come that 21.9 by 2, that is 10.95. So number of available user, number of users, number of available channels, that is 10.95 multiply by 60 divided by 1.76. It will come 373.30 users. Now you can see here when not sharing procedure 307 channels are available, but if sharing procedure return 373 channels are available for the communication, for the conversation. Clear? So this is basically the channel assignment strategy, especially for the channel sharing strategy. Clear? So these are the channel assignment procedure. And next one is the channel borrowing procedure. Channel borrowing procedure is, this is the fixed channel assignment. Clear? If all the channels are busy, now the one cell borrows some channels from the adjacent cell. And not the temporary basis, on the fixed or permanent basis. Clear? So this is the procedure of the channel borrowing system. Thank you.